So in the last video, we have seen how to use Workbench and how to connect your Workbench with MySQL Server and how to create a database. In this video, we'll see how to create tables in that database. So we have already said use ABC. Now what we'll do is once you have used the database, we can create a table. So in order to create a table in SQL, okay, so we have to use a lot of SQL query. So in order to create that table, we can simply say create table. So that's the that's how it works. So we have to say create table, and then we have to mention the table name. So for this example, let me create a table as a student. So we'll pass in the student table, I'll be having two columns. First will be roll number. The type of, so you have to specify the name of the column and the type of the data it will be stored. Since roll numbers will be in number format, we can simply use int. So int means integer. So you can also use integer, you can also use int, choice is yours. And then we can use something called as, we need one more column, which is, let's say, sname. Now in this sname, the type of sname will be string type, so you'll be having your names, right? So this when you say you want to store a string, we can use something called as varchar. And this varchar will specify the size. Let's say I'm using 20 letters will be, maximum it will be having 20 letters. Now why varchar, why not char? Is because when you say char 20, it will occupy all the 20 characters even if you are not using it. But varchar will use only those that number of memory, the number of fields you have given. So always prefer varchar because it stores your, it saves your memory. And to execute this query, again, we can simply do Alt in, Control Insert. So as you, sorry, Console, sorry, Control Enter. So as soon as you say Control Enter, it will execute the query. And you can go here in this schema section. If you expand your table, it's not there. Let's refresh. So you can see there's a table called as Student. Now, how to know the description of this table? What we can simply do is, we can say describe, which is DESC, and the table name, which is student. And if you say control enter, it will describe your table. So this is so this is your roll number, the type of the field, null values allowed, yes. This is sname, varchar, and we have null value again allowed. So this is how we have to create a table and this is how we have to create a table, right? Now the second thing we'll be doing here is we'll say we'll insert some values in the table. So let me just drag it down. Okay, let's insert some values. So in order to insert values, what we need is we have to say insert. So to insert values, we have to use this keyword, which is insert. Now in SQL, we have two types of statements. One is DLL. So let me just write those things first. So there's something called DDL and DML. So DDL stands for data definition language, and DML stands for data manipulation language. And we have something called DRL, or some people also say it as DQL, which is, so DRL is data retrieve language and DQL is data query language. So you can, you know, when you insert, when you create a database, when you create table, when you drop table, everything comes under DLL or DDL. And when you insert values, when you update values, when you delete values, it comes under DML. And when you fire a select query, it comes under DQL. Since we are working on, we want to insert values, it will be DML. So in DML, we don't use a keyword called table, okay? So we, whenever you see table, it becomes a DML statement. So like create table, drop table. So we, it's, it all belongs to DDL. Since we want to insert values, so we'll say insert into, and we have to specify table name. Table is student here. And then we have to say values. What are the values you are inserting? Let's say the first column will be one, which is the roll number, and second will be my name, which is Navin. Okay, and to execute this query, again we can say control insert. So you can see, yeah, so it is, it has affected one row. Now we'll insert next value, which is two. We'll say this time it is Rahul. Let's insert, and you can see it is inserted. Now, in order to see the values are inserted or not, we can simply fire a select query. So we'll say select star from, so select star from the table name, which is student. So how it works, so we have to specify first select, that means we want to fetch data from the table. We have to specify star, which simply means select all the columns from and the table name. So it will fetch all the data from the table. Okay, and if I say enter, you can see the result here, which is, let me close this, I don't want this. Is that thing? Okay. So let me fire this query again. Okay, so you can see it is 1 Navin and 2 Rahul. Clear? So this is how we have to fire the select, the create table query, insert query, and select query. So in the next tutorial, we'll talk about different queries in MySQL. Okay. So thanks for watching, and do thumbs up if you like that video, because the more you like, the more you get. So thanks for watching, and do subscribe for further videos.